Good afternoon, Rory.
Good afternoon, Peter. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you very much. Are you at Newbury this afternoon?
I certainly am, and it's very, very windy outside. I was going to do this call from outside, but I decided to take shelter in the warm. I don't think it's raining at present, but the ground is going to be very, very testing out there.
Before we talk about the three main races of the afternoon, any movement early on for the other races?
Well, Calypso very strong in the opener in the juvenile hurdle for Paul Nichols. 2-5 for the opener. He's 14-1 to win today and in the Triumph hurdle. And in the handicap hurdle at 150, we're paying out a quarter of the odds each way in that race. Upswing, the 3-1 favourite. Andy Kelly, next best at 4-1 for Emma Lavelle. And that one's our worst result. But we're seeing fairly even spread of money in that race.
Now, as a presenter, I'm just going to give you my selection for that race. What price have we got Kill Murphy?
He's 8-1. I actually backed that one myself last night. I mean, he's got a good chance up in Trip and in heavy ground.
Oh, nice one. So hopefully anyone watching this, if there is anyone watching, they can get on early at 8-1. Let's talk about the three big races, and there are some big races at Newbury today. The Denman Chase, how are we looking on the market there?
Well, I've probably just got an update for you because Alpha Roth was the subject of our Happy Hour promotion. So from 11 until 12, we were 7-4 about Alpha Roth, which was clear top industry price. Obviously, Happy Hour has just ended, so he's now 6-4 and a massive loser in the book. Harry Topper and Katenko, next best at 3-1. Walk on 9-1 and Vino Griego 14-1. But definite reasons to take on the favourite. He didn't get home at Kempton. It's very testing, as I said today, and you know, this Trip just might test him a bit too much. So a doubt over him staying and reason enough to take him on. But if you do fancy him, as I say, 6-4 today, and he's 20-1 to win today and in the Gold Cup next month at Cheltenham.
OK, and a renamed cash out Betfair cash out chase at 3 o'clock. Should we be dodging bullets?
Well, Module has been the one for money. Can we please call it the Game Spirit? Because that's what it's called.
Absolutely.
That's the race.
Yeah, absolutely.
The Game Spirit. Module has been very popular. A couple of lumpy bets on that one as well for Tom George. 2-1 into 6-4 favourites. Dodging Bullets was very weak earlier. Out to 2-1, but we've seen a bit more money for it since. And it's now 7-4, so almost challenging for favouritism again. But those two seem to be being backed at the exclusion of everything else. 6-1 bar those, so it does look like a two-horse race. I mean, we've got, actually, we're now at 6-1 Devitt Cry, 13-2 Reyes Star, and 25-1 Majala, and 40-1 Lord of House. I think there's one of them's going to Warwick, if I'm not mistaken.
But, yeah, I was going to ask you about Lord of the House, because it was declared to run at both. From Matt, you're suggesting possibly Lord of the House, the Charlie Mann-trained horse, is more likely to go to Warwick. Is that?
I suspect so. We should get clarification soon on that. They're both in the betting, obviously. It's non-runner, no bet. So that's why, you know, it doesn't really matter too much if you're a punter. But, it'll be interesting to see where these horses actually do turn up. But Warwick is going to be pre-testing as well, so rock and a hard place, really.
Okay, well, the big race of the day is obviously the Betfair Handicap Hurdle. I mean, £86,000 to the winner. I mean, it's some race. We'll be talking here on the panel about all these races later on this afternoon. Where's the money gone for particular horses in this race?
Well, we top price every runner in the Betfair Hurdle, and it's interesting because normally you get a couple of horses that punters latch onto at the exclusion of the others because we're going to be at biggest price about them. But we've seen an even spread. 7-1 favourites, Irish Saints, but we've seen some decent bets at big prices. Jumps Road was back to 80-1. That's now 66-1. Gib River was back to 33-1. That one's now 25-1. Crispy Green has been popular for Gary Moore. I think he'll love the conditions. He's 28-1. But the biggest loser in the book, unsurprisingly, is Poet, after being put up by Price Wise. Clive Cox's charge, he was as big as 33-1. 22-1 earlier, he's now 20-1 and by far the biggest loser in the book. But as I say, top price to field, one we can't give away at the moment, seemingly, is Rolling Star, that which was anti-post favourite at one point, or definitely near the top of the market. That one now 16-1.
Right, okay. Irish Saint, what price were you, Irish Saint?
7-1 favourite, 9-1 bar.
Okay. All right, lovely. Is there anything else on the Newbury card a bit later on that you just wanted to quickly mention?
Well, the last two races, it could be a quick Harry Fry double. He saddled the favourites in both. Mendip Express, who was a doubtful runner early in the week, but it looks like they're going to take their chance. He's a 13-8 favourite for the novice chase and one of the favourites for the National Hunt Chase at the festival. And then in the last, Thomas Brown, who won over course and distance before the turn of the year. He's been very well backed. 7-4 favourite from 9-4. And of course, Harry Fry won the race last year with Oscar Rock. Next best in that bumper, the listed bumper, is Seven Nation Army for David Pipe. And that one's 100-30. Won well at Ascot before the turn of the year. But all the money suggests a big run from Thomas Brown there.
Okay. And finally, before you go, one horse that you don't want winning today from the bookmaker's point of view, where all the money been? On one horse.
Our worst result probably is Module. As I say, that would have been very popular in the game spirits. And 6-4 favourite now. And that one's a bad result. But I dare say Poet would be a bad result. Right. And Alpha Ross would be a bad result as well.
Right, OK. Well, hopefully we can take some of your money this afternoon. But thank you very much for joining us, Rory.
Thank you.
And have a good day at Newbury. And hopefully, you know, from both points of view, we can win some. And maybe you can win some as well.
We shall see. And just quickly mention tomorrow, some really good racing at Leopardstown. And from 9 o'clock in the morning, with top price every runner in the Irish Hennessy, which should be an absolute cracker.
And it's going to be a pointer to one of the big races at Cheltenham as well, isn't it?
Hopefully some Gold Cup pointers there, and maybe some Ryanair pointers too.
Absolutely. Thank you very much indeed, Roy.
Cheers, Peter.